Hello students, welcome to the class. Today we are going to discuss some of the MCQs in chemical modeling. Okay, look at here. Ionic compounds do not exhibit space isomerism. Ionic compounds do not exhibit the isomerism. Covalent compounds exhibit isomerism. But ionic compounds do not exhibit isomerism. They are asking what is the reason. The reason is ionic bond is non-directional bond. Ionic bonding is non-directional bonding. Next, the most favorable condition for ionic bonding are, so which one are the most favorable conditions for ionic bonding? Remember Fadden's rules. In Fadden's rules, large cation size, small anion size is the most favorable conditions for ionic bonding. Like that we told. So for an ionic bonding to be formed, cation must be large, anion must be small. So large cation, small anion will give you ionic bonding. Next, indicate the nature of bonding in CCl4 and CaH2. What is the nature of bonding in CCl4 and CaH? CCl4 is a covalent compound. CCl4 is a covalent compound. CaH2 is ionic. CCl4 is covalent. CaH2 is ionic. Next. Which set contains only covalently bonded molecules? Which set contains only covalently bonded molecules? So they are asking only the covalent bondings. Look at those things: BCl3, SiCl4, BCl5, NH4Br. Look at this one: BCl3 covalent bonding, SiCl4 covalent, PCl3 also covalent. You know about this. So they given different molecules. Those molecules are BCl3, SiCl4, BH3, NH4Cl. Next, NaI. So, like that they given list of compounds. Now they are asking which compound have the covalent bondings. So, in BCl3 you see only covalent bond. This one also contain covalent bond. This one also contain covalent. This one contain ionic bond. This one contains ionic bond. Okay? This three contains the covalent bonds. Next. In which of the following state of compounds, the magnitude of hydrogen bonding will be maximum and in which case it will be minimum? So they are asking the magnitude of hydrogen bonding. In solids, hydrogen bonding magnitude is more, and in liquid and in gases, ionic bonding, hydrogen bonding magnitude is less. These things are the theories you have to remember. Next, which of the following is negative overlap? So they given different types of orbital representations. which one shows the positive overlap. So they are asking positive overlap. Look at the diagrams carefully. If plus plus minus minus are there, then they are involving in positive overlap. If one of the orbital plus, another orbital minus is there, then they involved in negative overlap. Okay, wherever you see like this diagrams, like this orbital representations, if plus and minus are there, then remember this one is negative overlapping. If plus and plus or minus are present, they are involving in positive overlapping. Okay. Now look at this one. Overlapping takes place when properly oriented orbitals are comes near. So, but here the orbital overlapping is not proper. Here the orbital overlapping is not proper. So hence this is called zero overlapping. This is zero overlapping. This is zero overlapping. This is negative overlapping. Plus and minus are there. Plus and minus are there. So this is zero overlapping. This is positive. This one also positive. Next, ninth one. The number of sigma and pi bonds present in a molecule of tetracyanoethylene. So they are asking number of sigma bonds and pi bonds in tetracyanoethylene. So this is tetracyanoethylene. Count how many pi bonds are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 pi bonds are there. Find out how many sigma bonds. Between two atoms, only one sigma bond is present. So 1, 2, 3, 4, sorry, somewhere it is not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 sigma bonds. So if a tetracyanoethylene contains 9 pi bonds and 9 sigma bonds. Next, another question. Which of the following is correct order of sigma bond strength? Sigma bond strength. Sigma bond strength order is PP, sigma PP. Orbitals are stronger bonds than sigma SP orbitals overlapping, than sigma SS orbitals overlapping, than pi PP orbitals overlapping. This is the order of orbitals overlapping. This is the order of orbitals overlapping. Sigma PP orbital overlapping is stronger than sigma SP orbital overlapping. It is stronger than sigma SS. It is stronger than pi PP. Suppose here some options are given. So this is the order of four sigma bonds and pi bonds. Now they are given like this. 2S, 2S. 1 is Yes, yes. Okay. Now look at this sigma 1, EPR becomes from the points. Then SP. Okay. After that, yes, yes, 2S, 2S. Because when compared with 2S and 3S, which one have the big S orbitals? It is third shell S orbital. It is second shell S orbital. Which one is larger one? 3S. Larger one means less bonding. Smaller one means more bonding. So order is 2p 2p greater than 2s 2p greater than 2s 2s greater than 3s 3s. Okay, so order of bonding. Third one greater than. Third one greater than. Second one greater than. First one greater than fourth one. So this is the bond order. So bond strength order. Next, as the S character in hybrid orbital increases, bond angle also increases. I will show you how this happens. What they are asking, as S character increases in hybridization, as S character increases in hybridization, what happens to the bond angles? What happens to the bond angles? As S character increases, what happens to in hybrid orbitals? So this is the question. Now take the different types of hybrid orbitals. SP3. In SP3 orbital, S percentage is 25%. In SP2 hybrid orbital, S percentage is 33.3%. In SP hybrid orbital, S character is 50%. Okay. In SP3, S character is 25%. In SP2, S character is 33.3%. In SP, S character is 50%. In SP3, bond angle is 109 degrees, 28 minutes. In SP2, bond angle is 120 degrees. In SP, bond angle is 180 degrees. So, what happening here? As S character increases, bond angle is also increasing. So, as S character increases in hybridization, bond angle is also increases. Next, which of the following statement is not correct? So they are asking the wrong statements. First one, hybridization is a mixing of atomic orbitals prior to their combining into molecular orbitals. what it means. Hybridization is one. Can you remember the definition of hybridization? Intermixing of atomic orbitals. Is it or not? So hybridization definition, they are saying the definition of some part of definition. So some part of definition is given in the form of objective, in the form of an option. So what is that part of definition? Hybridization is intermixing of atomic orbitals. That is the first option. So it is correct statement, but we need wrong statement. For this question we need the wrong statement. So first option is correct. Come to the second option. sp2 hybrid orbitals are formed from 2p atomic orbitals and 1s orbitals. sp2 hybrid orbitals are formed from 2p atomic orbitals and 1s orbitals. So sp2 hybridization is by intermixing of 2p orbitals and 1s orbitals. Next, d2 sp3 hybrid orbitals are directed towards the corners of octahedron. So yes, it is correct. sp3 d2 hybridization, in sp3 d2 hybridization, hybrid orbitals are directed towards the corners of octahedron. These are hybrid orbitals. Now these are present at the corners. So this is octahedron. So all hybrid orbitals are directed towards the corners. So this is correct option. Now we will go for another option. In sp3 d2 hybridization, all at 90 degrees to one another. All orbitals are at 90 degrees to one another. Is it correct? No. The orbitals which are present on the planar orbitals have 90 degrees, and the orbitals which are at the plane and perpendicular to the plane also have the 90 degrees. So planar orbital, 4 planar orbitals are present here. This is the orbital which are present at the perpendicular to the plane. So the bond angle is. Here what we are asking, all are 90, but look at here, the orbitals which are present on the axis, axial orbitals, the axial orbital bond angle is only 180 degrees, the axial orbital bond angle is only 180 degrees, okay. Which of the following pairs of species have identical shapes? Which of the following pairs of species have identical shapes? So to find out the shapes, look at the number of bond pairs and lone pairs. If you don't know, then use the formula which we discussed yesterday to find out hybridization. So to find out number of electron pairs, to find out number of electron pairs,
I given a formula. Again, I will show you that one because it is very important. Because repeatedly they are asking the questions which can be solved by using this application. Number of electron pairs is equal to A plus half into G minus V plus R minus E. So this is the formula which can be applied to find out electron pairs. This A shows us the number of bond pairs. A shows us the number of bond pairs. This part will tell us number of lone pairs. Okay? This one gives us the number of bond pairs. This one will tell us the number of lone pairs. A is number of atoms surrounding central atom. A is number of atoms surrounding central atom. G is group number of the central atom. V is valency of central atom. Next, for cations, you do minus charge. Do minus charge. For anions, you do plus charge. So here they given some options, NO2 plus, NO2 minus, like that. So now I am using NO2 plus. Find out number of lone pairs and bond pairs. If same number of lone pairs and bond pairs are present, they have the similar shape. So NO2. A is number of atoms surrounding central atom. So number of electron pairs. Is equal to 2 plus half into G means group number. Nitrogen belongs to fifth group. Next, valence. Valence is that twice the number of oxygen atoms. Here, how many oxygens are there? 2. Make it twice, become 4. Here, plus is there. So, this is the cation. If cation is present, you have to do minus charge. Minus charge. Minus. So, this one become 2 plus 0. Okay, means it contains 2 bond pairs and 1 lone pair, 2 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. If someone will ask you what is the hybridization, then make it the number of electron pairs. So if 2 is the total number of electron pairs, then this one is sp hybridization. If 2 is the total number of electron pairs, then this is sp hybridization. Next, another one is L12-. Now take this one. How many atoms are running in the central atom? 2 plus half group number 5 minus valency. Valency is the twice the number of oxygen atoms. How many oxygens are there? 2 oxygen. Make it twice. Become 4. Here minus is there. If minus are there, then add plus. Okay. Now what happens? Become 6 minus 4. 2 plus 1. So total number of electron pairs are 3. If 3 is the total number of electron pairs, then it is sp2 hybridization. This is number of non pairs. This is number of sp2 hybridization, 2 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. Next, PC alpha, DR alpha. So total number of electron pairs A 5 plus half into G group number 5 minus valence 5. So it becomes 5 plus 0. It is sp3 hybridization. So 5 non pairs. Bromine 7 plus 7. How many atoms are surrounding? 5 plus half into 7 minus 5. 5 plus 1. 5 plus 1 means it is sp3 V2 hybridization. 5 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. This is square pair. Next, take another example. XeF4, not XeF4, ECl4, XeO4. So this one also same. Oxygen group, helium, oxygen group. So 4 plus half into 6 minus 4. 4 plus 1. Sp3 hybridization. 4 bonds, 1 pairs, 1 lone pair. Next, XeO4. 4 plus half into xenon 8 group. 8. So 4 plus 0. Sp3 hybridization. 4 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. So this is about all the this is the application of the formula from which you can find out number of bond pairs, lone pairs, total number of electron pairs and hybridization. So now they are asking which of the following pairs of species have identical shape. Identical shape means you have to get the same number of electron pairs, same number of bond pairs and lone pairs. So which one has the same number of lone pairs and bond pairs? You get here 2 plus 0, 2 plus 1, here 5 plus 1, 5 plus 0, 4 plus 1, 4 plus 0. So which one has the same number of electron pairs? No. Okay. So our option is none of the above. But this is very important concept from which you can find out the hybridization, number of lone pairs, number of bond pairs and the shape. Okay. So this is about the next question. The structure of PBr4- PBr4 plus structure of PBr4 plus they are asking the structure of PBr4 plus 4 plus half into group number first aspect of the group minus valence 4. Here plus is there, we know the minus. So 4 plus 0. 4 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. So this is sp3 hybridization. So if sp3 hybridization with the 0 lone pairs are present, then it becomes tetrahedral. Next. Number of lone pairs in ammonia, water and in HCFP. Use the same formula. You get the number of lone pairs and bond pairs. If you need number of lone pairs and bond pairs, use this formula. Easily you will get the answers. Okay? So you pack, you count for these molecules, number of lone pairs and bond pairs for ammonia, for water, for HCFO, and for SO. You count the number of lone pairs and bond pairs and find out hybridization. The dipole moment of chlorobenzene is 1.5 d. The dipole moment of another one. Dipole moment of chlorobenzene is 1.5 d.
and symmetrical manner.